particularly now, the way, you know, society is moving and the world is moving, none of these things are permanent. Even disabilities, nowadays such wonderful, you know, progress is happening in terms of medical and technological progress, that even a person with disability, where one used to say that now he is disabled, let's say a person who is blind, a person who is deaf, a person who has lost the use of his legs, he won't be surprised if in the next few years these people get back, if not to 100%, at least 80% normalcy of using. I had a very dear friend who was an IPS officer, a police officer, superintendent of police, went to a very remote district where he was supervising over a jatra, where millions of people come, and no facilities were available there. He ran a fever, and the fever kept getting worse and worse, but he knew that this next 72 hours is crucial. If he leaves the place and goes away, and if there is a riot or something like that happens, he's going to be in trouble. He's the officer in charge of the district. So he stayed put. The fever went to his brain, and the effect was that he lost his hearing. Now you imagine a police officer who cannot hear. His father was a military, you know, war hero of the 1962 vintage. He went and, you know, spoke to the President of India, and he said that I will train my son to do certain activities which do not require hearing, but don't throw him out. So the government gave him a chance. He started computerizing the, all the police stations and networking them in Maharashtra. Because of his one effort, their entire, you know, all crime records all over the state were available. Any police officer sitting in one police station could access that name and find out whether he has a police record somewhere else. The moment he did that, they started recognizing his ability. Then they made him superintendent of police of the wireless, that's how he went on. They didn't give him promotions. He came close to retirement, and then he got what is known as a cochlear implant. Hearing aids were of no use to him, but a cochlear implant brought back 80% of his hearing. And then he went back and he said, for 20 years you denied me promotions. Now you better give me what my due was. And he fought it and got the thing back. Now this is to tell you, a person at that stage of life could have given up and said, see how, what a miserable creature I am, I've lost my hearing, what can I do? If he himself had said, how can I work as a police officer, let me go and do some other work or something of that sort, how miserable he would have been. But because he loved himself, because he had that thing in himself, that okay, if I can't do this, can I do that, can I do this, can I do that, and then he went ahead. And finally his reward was that he got some 20 years of salary arrears, which made him a millionaire overnight. Today he has a palatial bungalow in which he lives post retirement, because of all the money that he got lump sum, which was denied to him. Incidentally, there was a very nice anecdote about this. There was another man apparently who had lost his hearing, a very rich elderly man who had tons of money. He was the head of a big business empire and all that sort of thing. He had lost his hearing. When this new technology came up, cochlear implant, he had a friend who was a ENT surgeon. And that man called him and said, hey, you got this facility, would you like to avail of it? He said, sure. Money was no criteria for him, it costs a few lakhs. So he got that cochlear implant done. And then the doctor sent him back saying that, come back after 1 month, I will review. You may have some problems initially. So come back after 1 month, if there is any issues, I will take care of that. This man goes back after a month and the doctor asks him, is everything okay, any trouble, anything of that sort. He said, no, minor, this thing getting used to this and that, and sometimes if there is a particular decibels, it screams in my ear and all that. That's only getting used to it, no issues. The doctor said, your family must be very happy that now you can hear. He said, no, I have not told my family that I can hear. And I've already changed my will 3 times in the last 1 month. That was beside the point. But what I am saying is that the way things are going, if you find yourself inadequate in something, your worst enemy is not that. If you find that I am poor, everybody else has money, I don't have money. Today, as I said, the way opportunities are even the poorest of poor person, if he has some talent in something or the other, he can start making money and go higher. He may already be 30 years or 60 years old, it doesn't matter. Even now he can move on and do things. Somebody has bad health, healthcare is improving fantastically. Something which was earlier told that no, there is no cure for it, today cures are coming up for it. You have any other issues, you can do it. The only thing that you know is that you need to value yourself and you need to like yourself so much that you say that I am worth it. God doesn't produce junk. So if I have been given life, there is a purpose for it. Let me try and see what best I can do within these limitations.